Hey guys, it's Clay Archer, CEO of DPC Technology, and today we're going to do a head-to-head comparison of the Loop Deck Live and the Elgato Stream Deck. The Stream Deck has been sitting on my desk for a couple of years now. I bought it as a Black Friday impulse buy a couple of years ago, and I set up a bunch of pages and subpages and I really dove into it. Like a lot of tech, I found I wasn't using most of the features. But after a year or so, I started to rely on a couple features so much that I was considering buying one for my home. I'm into photography, so I've been looking at the Loop Deck products and their evolution over the last couple of years. I really liked the original Loop Deck and the Loop Deck Plus, but I didn't think I could justify a photography-only device. When the Loop Deck CT came out, I was interested, but the price was just so high I couldn't justify it. But when the Loop Deck Live came out, and I could essentially get the features of the Stream Deck with the photo editing versatility of the Loop Deck Plus, I jumped. Now that I've had a little while to compare the two, I can tell you which one to get. And spoiler alert, it depends. Let's start out with the physical units themselves. The Loop Deck Live has 6 dials with LED labels, 8 hard buttons, and 12 LED buttons with haptic feedback. The unit comes with a USB-C cable and a USB-C to A adapter, and it also comes with a little stand. The price comes in at $269, and there's links to everything in this video in the description below. The Elgato Stream Deck has 15 customizable LED physical buttons or keys. It has a built-in USB-A cable, and it also comes with an adjustable stand. Its price comes in just under $150. The build quality of both units is great. They're rugged and sturdy. And as far as the stands go, I use the stand on the Stream Deck, but I lay the Loop Deck flat. I think this is personal preference. However, the Stream Deck's stand is more sturdy and it just feels right. If you nudge the Loop Deck the wrong way, it can fall off the stand. I also give a definite advantage to the Stream Deck for the physical keys. Most of what I rely on the Stream Deck for is streaming and video production, which require that I'm not looking at the device. Okay, here's one of my main things that I use the Stream Deck for, and I think that this is where this has got the most power. As you can see, I've just got my start and my display buttons here on my Stream Deck, and this is for OBS. And so if I want to record, I just quickly click this record button. It's actually recording now. If I click again, it's going to stop. And I have a display button. Typically, the camera that you're seeing me in right now is also going through my OBS, and I can click between the camera and the desktop really quickly just by using these two things. And what's awesome about the Stream Deck just in general is all of these buttons are very tactile. And so I can sit here and click buttons and never lose eye contact with the camera. And I think that that's probably the biggest feature of this for me, is that these physical buttons really are very easy to push, very easy to kind of have your hand on like you're a musician playing an instrument, rather than trying to find a little screen that's got, it has the haptic feedback on that, but it's just not the same on the Loop Deck that it is on the Stream Deck. So if I'm sitting, if I was on Twitch, or if I was a gamer, or I'm somebody that's going to live stream, this is really the killer feature for me of the Stream Deck and why I like it here on my desk. Because the keys fit nicely under your fingers, you can easily stop and start videos, switch inputs, change displays, all without looking down. This is a major selling point for me, and it makes the Stream Deck an OBS must-have. But the Loop Deck has a trick up its sleeve for OBS too. The 6 adjustable knobs are awesome for anything that you need to adjust that has a level or a slider. So in OBS, for instance, if you're doing a lot of audio input adjustments or fades between scenes, the Loop Deck is a great device. That being said, I've been using the Stream Deck in OBS for years, and for that application, it is my clear preference. All right, so I'm gonna jump into Lightroom real quick and do a really typical edit for me. These are some outside pictures of Alberto. Typically what I'll do is I'll just quickly zoom in on the eyeballs, and I'll go through and I'll rate each photo, just the ones that are in focus. The ones that are out of focus, I will put to a lower rating. And then I'll go into the develop module real quick, and I will go through the ones that were higher ranked, and I will then go ahead and start spinning the dials on it. So this one's got a little bit of overexposure. I'll bring that exposure down. I'll bring up the shadows. Maybe I'll bring down the highlights a little bit. Just real quickly, I'm not doing anything that's really major here. I might add a little dehaze to kind of sharpen it up a little bit, and maybe a little bit of clarity. I don't know, just kind of to taste. And honestly, for 90% of my pictures, that's all I'm gonna do. I may crop it and I'm just gonna go on and do an export. Some of the time I might go into HSLs, like in these ones where I'm comparing them to other photos that they all have to match on the webpage. I might go into the HSL sliders and maybe try and match the tone of the greens in the back there, and then maybe saturate the, I'll just do this overblown to show you what I'm doing. I just overblow the bushes there. Super quick, simple. If you're just doing those kind of basic edits, it's a wonderful little tool. I probably go a little bit deeper into maybe some tone curves, some stuff like that that I'll do with the mouse. But for 90% of my images, boom, I can get in there, get it balanced, get the highlights and the shadows right, and be done with it. That brings us to the software. Now, Stream Deck has had a lot more time to develop their software than Loop Deck has. And for me, it shows. That being said, I remember being frustrated with the Elgato early on when the software was not as well developed. But for now, some things are just easier to set up in the Stream Deck. If you want a simple web link button, let's say to YouTube Studio, it's a drag and drop and a cut and paste. It literally only takes a few seconds. All right, so I'm gonna really quickly go give you a use case scenario here that I think is where the Stream Deck really shines. If you jump into the software real quick, you can see that the actions on the right-hand side are, the default actions are really pretty simple. There's nothing really all that crazy to them. And they're just very useful. You can see this is my main desktop here. I've got my QuickBooks files and some of my ConnectWise stuff, my Adobe stuff. And then I've got these four web page links, basically YouTube Studio and Analytics, vidIQ, and my Amazon affiliate links. And then I've got a couple of OBS commands that I use all the time. So what I want to do really quickly is just add another web page link. And so I'll show you how easy it is to do here. I'm going to scroll down to the website icon here. Super easy, pretty intuitive. Hey, I want to link to a website. That's pretty simple. I'm just going to drag it on over to the button that I want to use. I'm not going to give a title to this. It'll make a little bit more sense in a second because I don't want the title to overlay over my icon. And I'm just going to type in here www.espn.com. And I'm going to click on the little add icon. And I'm going to select icon from file, and I've downloaded the ESPN icon there. And there you go. As simple as that. Now I have a button that if I click, it will launch Chrome and ESPN will fire up. Super easy. On the Loop Deck though, it's a macro and it's not super intuitive on how to make it. In fact, I'm not really sure I'm making the easiest or the fastest way still. All right, so now let's try and do the same thing over here in the Loop Deck software. I'm in the main screen here, so I'm gonna, because it's content aware, I'm gonna need to go down to Google Chrome. I'm gonna select that desktop, and this is basically the desktop that Google Chrome uses. I mean, in the left-hand side here, I've got all the actions and custom buttons here. And so really quickly, I just kind of would come in here and go web link, maybe, no link. Can I find something that looks like to me like it's just gonna be a web page button? And I never found anything. So, you know, some of these things are like new window, new tab, sounds about right, but I want it to go to a new tab and then do something like go to a web page. I couldn't find anything in here. I see a thing to go to web page links, but it is, that's like a page of links, but I never saw where I could create a link. So what I eventually did, and this could be wrong, somebody may inform me, and if you know a better way, please put it down in the comments, but I just went in and I created a custom link for each one. So I'm gonna go create a custom link. I'm gonna, I could name this action here, and I will call this ESPN. And then here, I'm just gonna push Control and T because I know that's create a new tab. Then I'm gonna go okay there. And then I'm gonna do a second action. And I don't want it to be a shortcut, this action. I'm gonna make this action a text. And I'm gonna go www.espn.com. I'm gonna go okay. And then I want one more action. I just wanted to press enter or return. And I'm gonna go, okay. And then I'm gonna go save there. Now that I have that button, I can drag that button onto the Loop Deck. And I can do what I need to do there. I can also just quickly, like I could in the Stream Deck, I can go and choose a file here for the icon. I'll do the same ESPN icon. And I'll go save there and save. And on the Loop Deck, if I go into a Chrome tab, you will see that icon. And if I click that icon, it will bring up ESPN. But you can see that that took quite a bit longer than it did for me to do it on Stream Deck. And sometimes because of the power of the Loop Deck, you're able to do a lot more, but sometimes you just want it to be simple and quick and easy. And I think that that's where the Stream Deck has got a little bit of an edge. But on the other side of the coin, the LoopNet's content-aware profiles are way more powerful than the Elgato's, and the potential of future growth is more robust. I downloaded several profiles myself, and I find myself using the buttons more often than I thought I would. They are also adding profiles all the time. The Excel, Outlook, and Chrome ones are pretty cool, and because they're content-aware, there's no reason not to load and use them. I just wish that LoopDeck used a simpler setup and had a better basic action panel like the Stream Deck's. Sometimes less is more. Okay, after all that, let's talk about who should get which unit. As I've said before, I'm an amateur photographer. I'll take a few hundred pictures of birds or vacation, and I want to quickly cull and edit them in Lightroom. I typically rate my photos and choose which ones to edit. Then I do a quick exposure, highlight, shadow, and clarity adjustments. From there, I might do an HSL adjustment and a quick curves, and I'm done. If that sounds like your Lightroom workflow, this unit's for you. If you're a wedding or a professional photographer, I probably would go with the LoopDeck Plus and a Stream Deck so you can really streamline your workflow. As for the rest of the Adobe stack, I'm using it a little bit in Photoshop, but I barely use it at all in Premiere. Probably the reason for that is I have a Logic keyboard for Premiere, and I'm just used to using those keyboard shortcuts in that workflow. I can imagine that Audition and any audio program with a profile will benefit from the dials. So in short, if you're a creator that needs to adjust levels or sliders, the dials are great. Also, if you use a ton of programs that already have LoopDeck profiles, I think the LoopDeck is worth the extra $120. Where I think the Stream Deck shines is for gaming, streaming, and OBS. If you need to keep your eyes on something and just trigger some actions, it's definitely the better unit. There's a real advantage to feeling the keys under your fingers. The Stream Deck is also easier to set up, and it saves you $120 for the regular version. Elgato also makes a Mini and an XL if you need more or less buttons. I really love my Stream Deck, and I think I personally have found the perfect setup. I use the Stream Deck at work where I stream and create video content, and I have the LoopDeck Live at home where I do more photo editing and creative stuff. I really hope that helps you out. And again, there are links to everything down below. If you have any questions or want us to test anything out, please ask in the comments down below. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you haven't already, and we'll see you in the next one.